Bishut, Moray, Verabotay, Dizdva Torah, Lishmat, Maurice Moshe, Ben Pnina, Dahan, Shalach, Le'olam. The parasha of this week is the parasha, there is so many stories in this parasha. One of the stories of this parasha, the death of Miriam and Nivea. And when Miriam and Nivea, she passed away, automatically, the water that the Jews had in the desert during 40 years, it was with Bishut Miriam Anivea. To tell you that Miriam Anivea, she was a big tzaddiket. Usually, always we talk about Abraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov, Moshe, Aaron, David HaMelech, Shlomo HaMelech. Always we talk about tzaddikim. But what about women? We don't talk too much about them. But here the Torah wants to teach us that even as the Gemara said, mitat tzaddikim mechaperet, the death of tzaddikim, it gives a forgiveness to averot that the Jewish people do. Not only tzaddikim, even tzadkaniyot, even women. That means don't think that because women, they don't study Torah, so they had no zchut. My friend, the woman had big zchut. When a woman dies, she can cancel billions of bad gezerot from Am Yisrael. Why? Why? We know that the woman, their purpose is, to take care of the house, the children, and they don't do the Torah. As you know, when Mashiach will come, Be'ezrat Hashem, all those who study Torah, like you, you will have the zichut to have tikkat hamitim. So the Gemara said, what about the woman? That means all the men will stand up after tikkat hamitim without their wives. I mean, the mother-in-law, I understand. But their wives, everyone with his wife next to him. So the Gemara said, yes, of course the wives as well. Even that they don't study Torah, they will come to life on Tichet HaMitim. Why? Because they supported their husbands. Because if the husband is a tzaddik, because of the wife. If the children are tzaddikim, look at you. You are here, you work, and your wife takes care of the children. So all what a tzaddik can become a tzaddik because of his wife. So automatically, the wife, the woman, when it will be tichet hamitim, so the woman maybe they will come to life first before the men. Maybe. Anyway, here the Torah wants to teach us specifically the death of Miriam. When Miriam passed away, the water disappeared. So the Jewish people they understood who was Miriam. Till now, they did not know the value of Miriam and Nevi'ah. Now that the water went, so now they value who is Miriam. And that's why there is a big rabbi, Rabbi Moshe Levi, he explained, he said, now I understand why the mitat tzaddikim, the death of tzaddikim, it gives pardon to the sin of the Bnei Yisrael, not only tzaddikim, even tzadkaniyot, even women tzadkaniyot. Here I would like to tell you a beautiful story that I read this morning. Beautiful story. One day there is a big rabbi in Yerushalayim who passed away. Big tzaddik. His name is Rabbi Yosef Chaim Zonfried Alav Shalom. One day he called his wife. He told her, I want to tell you what's going to happen between you and me in Gan Eden. So she told him, what? He told her, all my Gan Eden is bizchut because of you. She started to laugh. Because of me? Why me? Why? Every time you tell me bizchut of me, bizchut of me, you will have. You're Rabbi Yosef Zandel. You're the rabbi. You're the tzaddik. Why? So he told her, because when I will arrive there, of course, they will ask me a lot of questions. And I will tell them that all what I did, I did it with your zechut. Because if you wouldn't let me to do what I did, I would not be what I am now. Ah, so it's your wife. So okay, we give your wife Gan Eden, but you have to search what you did in your life. So they start searching about my life, and they will find out that I did few things that you were not next to me to avoid me not to do them. Uh-huh, very interesting. So what's going to happen? So it's going to happen that you are in Gan Eden, and me, they will treat me outside Gan Eden. So you, my wife, you the tzaddiket, you will be waiting for me. When you will see that I'm not coming, so you will start screaming, where's my husband? Where's my husband? So they will tell you, well, your husband is outside because he don't have Olam Haba. So she will tell him, she will tell them, but all what I am is bishrot of him. It's impossible that I am in Gan Eden and he's outside Gan Eden. All what I am today is because of him. So each one, and then they said, okay, we'll let him go. That means, how much you have to value Baruch Hashem? That's what the Torah said. Eiseh ezer kinegdo. Hashem, he said, I will give a support to the man. Who is the support? Not a car, not money, a woman. Isha, a support. I will give to the man a support. Bemet, this is the emet. You know, a man, all his life he's outside. And if he don't have a support in the house, it's going to be a problem. Yesterday, I received a couple, unfortunately, they want to divorce. But there is a lot of money in the middle. A lot of money in the middle. And the man, he said, I'm willing to give half of my money, even more than even everything, I want to divorce. So his wife, she said, but tell me a reason. And the reason was that no communication. All day he work, he come home, she's on the telephone, and the house, catastrophe. And they are rich. They have a woman, a maid in the house. But the lady, the wife, she wants to be in the calm. She will not let her do her homework. So the house is in a mess. Because the house is a mess. So the man, he said, I'm fed up. I can't stand it. I don't want to leave. I don't want to stay with her. I want to. Sometimes you see, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he give you everything. And not only he give you everything, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he made you to be a support for your husband. You know, a house. You know, we call a woman Ba'alat HaBayit, the master of the house. A house without foundations, there is no house. The house, you need a foundation for the house. And the foundation of the house is the woman, the support. A support for the man. So the man, the woman should understand to be the support of the man. And of course, don't forget, there was one big rabbi, Rabbi Shimshon Pinskus, Alav Shalom. One day there was a man who came to see him. He told him, Rabbi, Baruch Hashem, I'm going to have a book to publish. And to collect that money, it took me 10 years every time, $1 by $1. Now, Baruch Hashem, I have enough money, and I want your blessing. He told him, I will not give you my blessing. I want that you take that money, buy a gift for your wife. What? All my life, I was collecting that money to publish my book. You want to take all this money for yes? He told him, because if you wrote a book, because your wife lets you to write a book. So your wife need to have, she was your support Now you must give your Rabotai, this is the parasha of the week. The parasha of the week, Bemeta, I think this parasha, if, of course, Hashem has a reason, but this parasha, we should call her Parashat Miriam. The parasha of Miriam. It's only because of the tzniut, we don't call her Parashat Miriam. Only because, Miriam, the tzaddiket, Miriam the tzaddiket. And I think, listen to this. Maybe the Torah didn't give the name of Miriam. You know why? Because there is a pasuk that it said, "Zechor ma'asa Hashem li Miriam." Don't forget. Remember what Hashem did to Miriam. What she did, Miriam? What she did wrong to become leprous? What she did wrong? She was a tzaddiket. Instead of the Torah talk good about Miriam, she saved Moshe Rabbeinu. Bizchut Miriam. Miriam, she was the leader of all the women in the desert during 40 years. Miriam, Nivea, Miriam, all the women, when they need a halacha, they come to Miriam. Miriam, she was the Baalat HaBayit of all the Jews. Miriam and Nivea. And because she talked, she said, why Moshe Rabbeinu divorced Sipora? Not only she had a leprous, but Hashem said, remember what I did to Miriam. She had a leprous. Instead of remembering good things that Miriam did, the Torah wanted to tell us what the only bad thing that she did, and she didn't do it on purpose. She thought she was right. Look, just imagine if I divorce my wife and I am old in the yeshiva. Of course, one of you will tell me, why did you divorce your wife? Because I want to take care of you. Yes, okay. You can take care of us, take care of your wife. I mean, it's not, you understand me, it's not now. So that's what Miriam did. Yeah, that's what she did. She did, why Moshe Rabbeinu divorced his wife? Why? Because of the Bnei Israel. He can take care of the Bnei Israel. Baruch Hashem, he has a lot of people to help him today. So what's the problem? The answer is, Miriam, the mistake that Miriam did, Miriam, she's a clever woman. She should think, if Hashem he didn't tell Moshe what he did, so why I have to tell him what to do? Who I am to tell Moshe what to do? Moshe Rabbeinu is the prophet. Moshe Rabbeinu is the Baal HaBayit. If Hashem he didn't say nothing to Moshe, if look in the parasha of this week, because Moshe Rabbeinu, he got angry against the Jews, because the Jews, they say, hey, we want water. Okay. Why the water was missing? Because Miriam passed away. And Hashem wanted to show the Jews, look what you had during 40 years. Water. Bizchut Miriam. Now that Miriam passed away, there is no water. So Moshe Rabbeinu should calm them down. Yes, you're right. And you will pray to Hashem. Hashem, Ribbono Shel Olam, they need water. But Moshe Rabbeinu got very angry. Shimon HaMorim! He started to scream at them. The Ramban said, because he said that to the Jews, he did not understand the Jews. If a Jew had a problem, you must understand him. When somebody has a problem, try to give him some comfort, not to scream at him. Hey, it's because of you, it's your fault. It's my fault. I'm thirsty, I'm dying. So help me. And because of this, Hashem punished Moshe Rabbeinu. Can you imagine that? So my friend, all what Hashem did, he did only that Moshe Rabbeinu, alav shalom, that Miriam, she will be known among all the Jews, how much a tzaddiket she was. And that's why the Torah, I think, she don't mention the name of Miriam. This parasha, we don't call her Parashat Miriam. Why? Because automatically, if we mention Miriam, Miriam, she was leprous. Instead of thinking about the good things she did, we start thinking always, because a man always is negative, always we are negative. So a man, people will think, she had a leprous, she spoke bad. So the Torah preferred to avoid, not to talk, but the Torah mentioned that when she passed away, automatically, the Jews understood that the mitat tzaddikim, the death of a tzaddik, no matter a man or woman, that give forgiveness to the averot of the Bnei Israel. And beside this, that you should realize that hey, Hakarat HaTov. 40 days, 40 years, you had water Bisrot Miriam. Look, this is the proof. So my friend, how much every one of us should understand that how much we have to value what Hashem give us as a support. A woman, the wife, as a support. When she wake you up to go to shul, when she lead you, go to pray, and she take care of the children. And of course, how much you have to remember to take care of her, to help her on Friday. Do your best if you cannot help her on Friday because you work, so Thursday night, you must. She's your support spiritual, and she's your support home. So you as well, you have to be a support by good words. And I never heard my father, I am from Morocco, and I never heard my father calling my mother by her name. My wife, her name is Vivian. I call her Vivian, but my mother, her name is Madeleine Mazal. Never my father will call my mother, Madeleine. He will call her with a lovely name, Marie-Bess Madeleine. Marie-Bess, that means with all, may Hashem protect you from bad things, Madeleine. One day I told my father, but Madeleine is not a Jewish name. Why you call her? So he said, well, Madeleine is a biscuit, is some biscuit, and they are sweet. And your mother, she's sweet. That was my father, Alav Shalom. The way he considered my mother. And every time I remember when my mother, she used to go to do shopping, and when she's only a little bit late, he was very concerned. He said to light candles and to pray with the Zichut Zadikim that she will come safely. I mean, your wife, she could take a taxi. Oh, Hashem, she's gone. And my father, when she's late, he will light a candle, tzaddikim, why she's late? And he will pray. When she come, Marabas Madeleine, why you came late? Because at the time there was no taxis or the buses. And it was very kind. Why? Because always my father said, how did she accepted me for 40 years in the house. Today, the corona year, how many people did go divorce? You know why? Because they were fed up to see the husband, or they were fed up to see the wife all day long, the day. For me, it was the best year. Why? Because I wanted to learn who's my wife. I wanted to know who is she. And I discovered my wife only this corona year. Bemet, huh? And now I will not fight her anymore. Allez, bracha v'atzlacha, kel ratzon.